construct the instruction level data dependence graph, we base that on storage resources, and a storage resource can be a variable, a register, or all of memory. And each such storage resource has two attributes: def, the instruction which defines it most recently, and uses the instructions which currently use that resource. When we construct this graph, we scan a basic block starting with the last instruction. That's the opposite of how we schedule the instructions. Then we take the graph that we construct now and select an instruction that should be the first in the new basic block. So we create the graph scanning backwards and schedule in the forward direction. This is only a matter of preference. It doesn't matter really, but I prefer this order. Okay, so let's see what we should do when we collect the graph, construct the graph. The nodes in the graph, they are the instructions. And what we want to do is to add edges. That means the data dependencies, such as true, anti, or output. Well, we ignore input dependencies in instruction scheduling. And also we want the initial set of candidate instructions. Recall, we do a topological sort, and we have a set of candidates which are the instructions which have no unscheduled predecessor in the graph. So that set is what we also want to find when we construct this data dependence graph. So we initialize the resources and the candidate set, and then we scan the basic block in the reverse order. Then we do some operations when we define a resource by this instruction, and then some other operations when we use the resource. And I mean the resource that that S uses, and then we add S to the set of candidates. S clearly can be removed from this set by an earlier instruction that we will see in the future. Okay, so let's see what happens in defined resource. First, we check if there already is an instruction which defines this resource. So say this is S and it defines X, and there is another instruction which also defines X, Y plus 2 for instance. Okay, so what we want here is an output dependence from S to T. Okay, since, well, we should not reverse this order of S and T clearly, and then we delete the def R, that means T, from the set of candidates. And then we set S to the instruction which defines X. Okay, so say now that we have Y equals X plus something, 3, and Z equals X plus something else. Then, as we will see later, these two instructions will be in the uses set of X. So what we do then when we are in S, we add an edge from S to each of these. That's a true dependence. Well, and another one, T to this one. Okay, and then we delete these two instructions from the candidate sets, and we also delete all the uses of X, since there is no instruction. I mean, say we have X plus 3 here. That instruction does not use this definition. So there should be no known uses after this, I mean, to this, when we are done with this one. So therefore we set it to the empty set. Okay, then we say we have A equals something, and and then we have X equals A plus B. Okay, so what we do now is to call use resource, then this is S then. Okay, and for each of the operands A and B. Okay, so we add S to the set of uses of A, and then we check if there is an instruction which defines A, and it's not the same instruction as it's not the S. Okay, and then we delete that instruction. So we delete this one from the set of candidates, and we add an anti-dependence between them. If we would have had this instead, X equals X plus 1, then def X would have been S when we come here. And so we add S to the uses, and we also check if we should create this anti-dependence edge, but we should not, because we cannot be dependent on ourselves. So therefore we have this test.